The Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum recently opened an exhibition of new and recent works by the Chinese-American artist Shen Wei. After coming to the United States, he would eventually be noted for his choreographing of the opening ceremonies for the Beijing Olympics. The current exhibition has scale and variety, but it's also in line with the spirit of the museum's founder. To tell us about the exhibition is the museum's Norma Jean Calderwood Director, Peggy Fogelman. Thank you very much for being with us, Peggy.
Thank you, Chris. It's great to see you again.
Okay, I want to first have you introduce this artist to our viewers. He has been pretty well introduced in the United States, but he has quite a life story in addition to his artistic resume.
Yes, well, he started, Shen Wei was an artist who started out in the in Chinese opera. And Chinese opera is a form that encompasses so many different things: acrobatics, voice, dance, set design, costume, lighting. And so he actually kind of grew up as an artist within a very eclectic art form that involves many, many different artistic forms. So almost from the beginning, when he was 9 years old, he entered the opera. He brought together many different art forms in his practice, and then he went on to be one of the founding members of the very first modern dance company in China. He was coming of age as an artist when China was beginning to open to the West in the 80s, and then he received a scholarship, a dance scholarship, to come to New York in 1995. And it was when he came to New York that he not only explored his career as a dancer and choreographer, but began making films and also continued his painting practice. So that's how he sort of branched off into all these different art forms. He also became an American citizen, but he really is a global artist in that he has had commissions all over the world. He has studios both in the New York area and in Paris, and he also does many, many projects in China still.
Well, the omnibus title for the exhibition is Painting in Motion. That does say something about paintings, but we're also talking about other media here, correct?
Yes, and the exhibition at the Gardner explores his work across media. So you see behind me these amazing paintings that are actually completely abstract, but when seen from a distance, they might evoke traditional Chinese landscape painting. And as you get closer, they're very gestural, and that kind of mark making, that kind of use of paint actually involves his motion. You can almost feel the way he's gesturing and moving across these vast expanses of canvas as he paints them. I mean, these canvases are, some of them are like 13 by 18 feet. So they're really gigantic. And also you as the viewer have to move in relation to the painting. You see them differently from far away, then up close, and you sort of move along them. So movement is inherent not only in the way he painted them, but the way that you, the viewer, respond to them. And then we also have his film screening in two different spaces in the museum. And one of the films is actually a Gardner commission, and he uses the palace of the Gardner Museum as a setting for his film. And then we also have his notebooks and dream journals installed in the exhibition, and we have a work of his on the facade of our new building. So we really explore the many facets of his artistry.
Well, when I look at the paintings behind you, I can see how the notion of landscape and composition is less static than what we're accustomed to in the West. But what does this exhibition say about his time spent at the Gardner, how he absorbed it as a creative environment?
Well, actually, you know, it might surprise some of your viewers that actually there are very close ties between Shen Wei and Chinese art and culture and Isabella herself. So Isabella traveled widely throughout Asia, and she amassed a very important collection of Chinese objects. She also kept travel albums of her journey. And she really thought of Chinese art and culture as part of her own spiritual exploration. She installed a private room that she called the Buddha Room that she used for meditation. And Shen Wei himself is a very spiritual artist. He sees all his work as being connected, and he sees the entire human experience as being connected to nature and to the spirit world, and that kind of meditative spiritual quality comes out in his work. So when he was in residence here at the Gardner, he was both painting, and you see the two paintings with a kind of golden background on the screen here are two paintings he actually executed while here as an artist in residence. And he also made a film here at the Gardner, and he was really taken by Isabella's sort of eclecticism, her passion for objects of all different types and all different art forms, which very much mirrors his own expansive understanding of the unity of all the arts.
Well, for most people who go to museums, the environment is packed, you know, people with their cell phones taking pictures. Now we have a pandemic, a whole different feel. How does that work with this exhibition?
Yeah, well, in general, I should say that the Gardner is very mindful of very strict safety protocols. Our visitors and staff are extremely conscientious in terms of mask wearing. We have capacity limits, time ticketing, social distancing, and hand sanitizer throughout the building, and very rigorous cleaning protocols. So our number one priority is to provide a safe environment for our visitors to come and experience the solace and the inspiration that art can provide. In this exhibition, because Shen Wei's works are so meditative and really connect to ideas about mindfulness and recentering, we think it's a really wonderful alignment with this moment and with the needs of our visitors at this moment. And because the works are such so large in scale, and as you can see, the center of the gallery is really open space. So it gives people a lot of space to move around without, you know, feeling like they're going to be crowded by anyone else. And in fact, the very large work behind me that's in black and white and grays is actually the subject of a guided meditation that you can access from your cell phone. So you can really have this recentering meditative moment at a time when there are just so many stresses in our society, and it's such a need that we're so hungry to fulfill at this COVID moment.
When I also look at what's described about this exhibition, I also picture it as, you know, not just individual works, but as this whole, you know, journey from one part of the museum to another. Did you discover some new potentials about the museum as a building and as a place when you mapped this out?
Well, you know, that's such an interesting question, Chris, because this is the first time we've had kind of an artist takeover of all our rotating spaces. So the exhibition gallery in our new building, and the films are screening in the performance hall of our new building. And then we have a film screening also in a small gallery off the courtyard of the historic building, and then a work on the facade. And you know, it does a couple of things. It unifies the historic building with the new building. It also, I think, helps our visitors understand what contemporary art is doing here at the Gardner, because there are such close ties between the work of Shen Wei and Isabella Stewart Gardner herself, and the way that she installed her collection and her passion for Asian art and culture. That it helped us understand how to make manifest those kinds of connections between the contemporary and the historical.
Isabella Stewart Gardner was also an avid reader, a great collector of books. And Shen Wei was inspired, I don't know if it was from her collection or not, but he certainly, you know, he spent a lot of time poring over the Divina Commedia by Dante, and that influenced some of his paintings. There's a lesson here, I guess, about where East meets West.
Exactly. And some of these, you know, kind of universal ideas. So when we think about Dante's Divine Comedy, Dante was really exploring a kind of ordering of the cosmos that goes from, you know, hell, if you will, up to the divine. And that idea, again, of a spiritual journey and everything being connected, you know, all these different spheres of the universe being connected, is very much central to Shen Wei's work. And so he actually started reading Dante in preparation for a commission that he had. It's going to be next year, the big Dante year in Italy. And so he was working on a commission for a performance in Italy and began reading Dante's Divine Comedy. And in fact, his reading of that work of literature resulted in an amazing set of works that are in the exhibition and being shown for the very first time. They were finished actually shortly before we had to ship them from Paris. So they really are brand new and never been shown before.
Well, I know this exhibit is also going to be putting a signature on the exterior of the building, so people can keep an eye out for that. But for more details, where can they get that online?
Please check out our website. We have all the labels for the exhibition are on our website. The guided meditation is on our website, and we'll be doing lots of virtual programming in conjunction with the exhibition. We have two wonderful partner organizations, the Pau Art Center in Chinatown and the Chinese Folk Art Workshop, both of whom we are collaborating with to create virtual programs for the exhibition, and those will all be posted on our website as well. And when you're in the exhibition, you can access all the labels in both English and Mandarin through QR codes.
Well, thank you very much for being with us and sharing the time and some of the space.
You're very welcome, Chris, and I hope to see you here in the exhibition. It goes through June 20th, so lots of time for people to come see it when you feel comfortable being in a public space.
Wonderful invite. Thank you very much. Peggy Fogelman from the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum. We'll have more news in just a moment.